Hey guys, alright, it's Paul here, and I have been getting a lot of questions about how to get into pharmacy school, like a summary type of video. So I'm gonna do a summary video, and if you have any questions about each of these topics, you know, go to my old videos. I talked in detail about each one of these questions and ideas. So first off, I'm gonna start out with, if you're at high school, the things that you want to pay attention to are, a lot of people wonder about SATs. So SATs don't particularly matter for pharmacy school unless you are trying to get into the early admission commitment type of program, where you get into a program straight out of high school. It guarantees you a spot, however, you have to meet certain requirements, meet certain GPA limits, and take a very specific course load to get to pharmacy school. And so I don't know too much about that, those programs, so you have to go and research yourself on those topics. Now, as for classes in high school, it doesn't really matter what you take. Volunteer work, you definitely want to start volunteering, especially in a pharmacy if you can. If not, then try to do any sort of healthcare type of volunteer work, and try to build your resume and your application. Now, for those who are going to undergrad, you know, college from high school, you're thinking, should I do community college? Should I do four-year university? You know, it doesn't really matter, because I came from myself a top 10 pharmacy school, and a lot of my classmates were from community college, so I don't see it as an issue if you choose community college or a four-year university. But I do want to note that this is just particular to my school that I went to and at my specific time, and 2008 is when I applied, and so things may have changed a little bit. So I know that my class specifically had about 75% of the admission of the class itself had bachelor's degrees. So if you want to keep that in mind, if you are trying to decide undergrad versus, a four-year university versus a community college. Now, prerequisites, pre-pharmacy, and what major to choose, okay? So pre-pharmacy is not a real major. It's just a set course of classes that are required, the prereqs, to get into a particular pharmacy school. So I suggest that most of you focus on the prereqs rather than actually finishing a bachelor's first. Once you get rid of your prereqs, start applying. You know, I wouldn't wait till you get your bachelor's before you apply for the first time. There is no reason that I can see why you would wait till you get your bachelor's degree and then apply. If you have your prereqs done, apply right away. There's no reason to wait. You're just wasting time and money. So if you don't get in when you have your prereqs done, then keep working on your bachelor's. Get it done. And for what major do you want to choose? It doesn't really matter. Most people fall under the category of a science major because the prerequisites are very similar. There's those who choose random majors as well, liberal arts majors, engineering majors. You know, a lot of people choose different things. And in particular, it doesn't really matter. So that's my take on that. Now, for priorities, GPA, research, volunteer work, extracurriculars, what you should do for all these things. So in my opinion, I would prioritize, if you are having difficult time managing your time and managing your GPA, I would focus on your GPA. Make sure that stays up. You know, it's really important to get extracurriculars in, volunteer work in, but it's not as important if it affects your GPA. You know, most schools require at least a 3.0 GPA. And, you know, if your GPA is hurting, I would focus on maybe one or two volunteer things just to have on your application, but I wouldn't go out and do 10 million things like a lot of people I know try to do. So what extracurriculars should you do? So most important thing, in my opinion, is getting pharmacy experience or some sort of healthcare experience. Because if I was on the committee looking at your application and interviewing you, and you told me you have no pharmacy experience, I am very, very skeptical believing you that this is truly what you want to do, because you really don't know what you're getting yourself into, as opposed to someone who has experience, has worked in a pharmacy. Then I can believe that they know what they're getting themselves into and they are passionate about what they want to do for the rest of their life. Now, for extracurriculars, there's a lot of different things you can do, you know, any sort of volunteer work, any sort of health campaign or anything that you want to do will help your application. There's also a lot of different clubs at schools, you know, universities and high schools that you can join to boost your application as well. Now, moving on to the PCAT. So for those who don't know what the PCAT is, it is similar to the SATs when you're in high school trying to get into a university. Now you're in a university trying to get to grad school, and that's what this exam is. It's a standardized exam to test your abilities in, you know, the sciences, the math, the reading, you know, the language, basically. And I would say that this is fairly important exam as well, because they use this as a metric, just like your GPA, to weed you out and determine if you deserve an interview or not. Now for letters of recommendation, most schools are going to require at least 3 letters, you know, and it's important to start working on building connections to get these letters. You know, you can even start during high school. And majority of the time, they're gonna require at least a pharmacist to write you a letter, and then a teacher or professor of some sort. So, or even an employer that you've worked for. So then, now you wanna make sure that you get these letters, and they're strong letters, you know, so it's really difficult to get good letters unless you know them and you've worked with them for many years. And so it's better to start early to build your connections to get these letters. Now, who should you get these letters from is another question. Is that your best chances to elevate your application is to get someone, a pharmacist that is well known, to write you a letter of recommendation, or even a faculty member at the School of Pharmacy, if you can somehow manage that, to write you a letter of recommendation. That will definitely help your chances. Now moving on to admission essays. So a lot of these pharmacy applications require you to write 1 to 2 to 3 essays to submit to their school for just their general application. And now these essays shouldn't be ignored, you know, they're somewhat important as well. You want to make sure you give yourself enough time to write a quality essay and have other people read it and critique it for you. And that's the most important thing about those. Now for something unique. Now I want to touch on this too, because there's a lot of students who, you know, have the package, have everything, have the GPA, they have the volunteer work, they have everything down, but they don't really have anything unique about them. So if you have all those things and you want to make yourself more unique and put yourself, differentiate yourself from the rest of the applicants, you want to find something to put in your application that makes you more memorable. And a lot of students try to do this by going to third world countries and doing volunteer work. And things include, you know, building, you know, new facilities for, you know, villages or anything that they don't have too much of, free healthcare, anything like that can really help your application. You know, since a lot of students know about this now and are doing it now, it's not as big of a wow factor anymore, but still not that many students do it. So I suggest trying to do something like that to make your application better. Now, if you can't go to another country to do these things, something you can do locally would be to start your own nonprofit organization or create a campaign where you raise money for a specific cause. So if you build a team of like 20 people or something like that, and then you raise a couple of grand to donate to a specific cause, that is somewhat unique and adds value to your application. Now the last thing I want to touch on is interviews. So once you finish all your applications, you get to the pharmacy interview, you want to really make sure that you've gotten a lot of practice with mock interviews, you know, gotten critique on how to interview, and, you know, really have thought about interview questions, because this is the deciding point of whether you get in or not. Because even if you have a 4.0 GPA and you have a perfect application, if you completely blow off the interview, they're not going to accept you, because, you know, they want to see if you fit to their program, if you really are passionate about this field. You know, so those are the main things I want to touch on, and I hope this summary video has helped some of you kind of see the big picture. And if you have any questions about any of the things I talked about, you know, I've covered these in detail in previous videos, so go check those out. You know, and I really want to thank you guys for keeping me motivated to make these videos, and subscribing and commenting and thumbing me. So yeah, so good luck on this round of applications coming this year, and the interviews coming up in the early winter and early spring. Late winter, early spring. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and remember, eat your vegetables.